if anyone has aspirations to attack minority communities or indeed to attack the Jewish community here in America, they'd have to go through me first.
Right. And so you condemn what Hamas did to innocent Israelis on October 7th, and you condemn what terrorists did to New York on 9/11.
Of course.
We have reached peak, do you condemn Hamas, ladies and gentlemen. That is Biden's nominee to be the first Muslim American appeals court judge in the country. Momentous, historic, first Muslim American appeals court judge, incredible. His name is Adeel Mangi, and he is a veteran litigator based in New Jersey, unanimously well rated among the American Bar Association, hailed for his legal and pro bono work by a range of organizations, including the AFL-CIO, the Coalition of Underrepresented Law Enforcement Associations, and more than a dozen prominent Jewish groups. And yet, here he is, a man of his distinction and honor, receives this nomination. And do you condemn 9/11? We're still on that. Okay. Republicans and actually Democrats are hounding Mr. Mangi over his religion and then their imagined connection to of that religion to, of course, terrorism. Let's get more specific. What are they screaming about? Republicans have accused Mangi of sharing views espoused by panelists who spoke at events hosted by Rutgers Law School's Center for Security, Race and Rights. Mangi previously served as a member of the center's advisory board in 2021 on the 20th anniversary of September 11, 2021. Attacks, the center hosted a roundtable discussion that featured several controversial speakers that Mangi said he had never heard of, and he didn't organize the panel. Sorry. But of course, because of his affiliation with the group, again, the group being Rutgers Law School, three Republican senators have demanded that he share his personal views on 9/11, which he, again, as you saw, repeatedly disavowed, condemned, and then they continued to prod him around Israel-Palestine, suggesting that maybe he was in favor of what happened on October 7th. Take a look.
Senator, I stated this earlier, but let me repeat it because I think it's critically important.
Do you condemn the atrocities of the Hamas terrorists?
Yes, that's what I was about to address, Senator.
And is there any justification for those atrocities?
Senator, I'll repeat myself. The events of October 7th were a horror involving the deaths of innocent civilians. That is contrary.
I'm going to ask the question again. Is there any justification for those atrocities?
That was going to be my next sentence, Senator, which is, I have no patience, none, for any attempts to justify or defend those events.
And yet, this is what the Republicans are going to do. They're going to smear him, and not just senators, but the people who have bought our judicial system, specifically the people who have bought our Supreme Court. Last month, the Judicial Crisis Network, a right-wing dark money group, began running ads accusing Mangi of being a radical, an anti-Semite, of being involved in the organization's efforts to teach students to hate Israel and to hate America and support global terrorism. By the way, the Judicial Crisis Network is a pet project of billionaire Leonard Leo, who has pretty much single-handedly been orchestrating all of our judicial life. Like, he has picked all of the Supreme Court nominees. He has been working to undermine civil rights for Americans. The guy is pure trash. But hey, he's funding ads that use video footage of a plane crashing into the World Trade Center on 9/11, overlaid with a headline about Mr. Mangi. He had nothing to do with 9/11, of course, or anyone who planned those attacks. The Council on American Islamic Relations and, interestingly, the ADL, Anti-Defamation League, have both publicly condemned the GOP for their treatment of Mr. Mangi. But Cenk, we're back here. And I just want to say, before I kick it to you, it is actually incredible that we don't have anywhere in our appeals court a Muslim judge. How is that possible? And look, I believe in the separation of religion and the state, obviously, that is in the Constitution. But isn't it funny that we still somehow don't have a representation of the people who are making judgments on our lives every single day in terms of religion. And many Muslims, thanks to 9/11, had been terrorized themselves, surveilled, followed, their communities ripped apart, entrapped into bogus, FBI sting operations. And you would want someone who comes from that community possibly to be ruling on your behalf, to say nothing of general religious freedom, of which it gets litigated and brought to courts every single day. And yet we don't have any Muslim Americans on these courts. It's just wild, but even wilder is what he's facing. And we'll get to what the Democrats are doing in a sec.
Yeah. So unfortunately, the Democrats not that much better on this issue, as you'll see in a second. But first of all, look, I don't need a quota. I don't need X number of Muslims in the appellate court system to represent the percentage that they are in the country, etc. But when there are none, you begin to get a sense of something being amiss. And then when you see a perfectly great candidate that's proposed that is clearly qualified, and all of a sudden everyone's asking him, do you support 9/11? What kind of monstrously racist question is that? That's not even close to not being racist. That's just saying, I hate Muslims. I think all Muslims did 9/11, and you're a Muslim, so you must love terrorists. And then they now apologize for October 7th. What did the brother have anything to do with October 7th? Why are you asking him about that? All right, Ted Cruz, why don't you apologize for the Holocaust? What do you mean? I didn't do the Holocaust. Exactly, dumbass. Okay, but under incredibly dumb racist ideology of Ted Cruz, what? You're a Christian. Hitler was a Christian. The Nazis on their buckle belts said, Gott mit uns. It means God is with us. Hitler said he was doing it for Jesus. So it must be Ted Cruz's fault. Do you see how stupid that is? That is the dumbest ideology in the world. But when it comes to Muslims, not only do the Republicans do it, a bunch of Democrats do it. A bunch of Democrats are going to vote no. Okay, and of course, for Republicans, they're like, you're a Muslim, we would never vote for you. Never, right? We think that you are responsible for every terrible thing that a Muslim has ever done. By the way, if you just say it about their Christian, like, hey, how about all the terrible, awful, horrific, monstrous things that Christians have done throughout world history, just because they're human and that's what humans do, they'd be like, oh, I'm so offended, I'm such a martyr, oh, I'm such a victim. My God, when we asked that cult lady that's on the Supreme Court now, Amy Coney Barrett, when Feinstein, back when she was alive and actually thinking and not, etc., she had once asked her about the cult that she was in. And they're like, how dare you? Right. How dare you ask her one sentence about her beloved faith? A Muslim guy comes in, they're like, 9/11, October 7th, Muslim mother effer, how dare you come in here and try to be a judge in America? Don't you know we despise Muslims? Come on, man. So now every once in a while, Republicans will ask me, hey, you're a populist, you hate the establishment. We don't like the establishment. Why don't you come vote for Republicans? Look, brothers and sisters, I'm born Muslim. I'm an atheist now. But like a lot of my, or almost all my Jewish friends are atheists as well. And they call themselves Jewish Americans because they're proud of their background, their culture, etc. And the same is true of me. I'm proud of my background, etc. So I also call myself a Muslim American. You think I'm going to vote for Republicans? All of your politicians loathe us. Donald Trump said he wants to ban us. Donald Trump just said about the Palestinians, just finish them. Well, this kind of sounds like a final solution. And I'm supposed to vote for you? You think that's a fair ask? Do you get how mental that is? If you're a Christian out there, imagine that a Democrat comes and goes, I think all Christians are responsible for every atrocity, the Holocaust, World War I, World War II. Christians are the worst. Apologize for all Christians.
Apologize for the Crusades.
Yeah, apologize for the Crusades. And by the way, give me your vote. Who would vote for them? Which lunatic in their right mind would vote for them? So no, Republicans, there's no chance I'll ever vote for those racists. And you want to call it, by the way, the the Republican guys who like split hairs. Oh no, technically that's not racism, that's bigotry. Oh, okay, well then feel great about that. It doesn't really matter what you call it. What it is hatred. And I'm not gonna vote for people who say, I literally hate you.
I mean, it seems that the smear campaign against this nominee is working, and it's working not just on Republicans who, as Cenk has pointed out, don't really need a reason to not smear a Muslim in this country. But it's working on Democrats too. Some Democratic lawmakers are concerned with Mungie's loose, very loose ties to an organization called Alliance of Families for Justice, which is a criminal justice group that advocates on behalf of incarcerated individuals and their families. Sounds cool, that to me, but okay. Republicans and law enforcement groups are opposed to Mungie, have portrayed it as an association that advocates for, quote, cop killers to be freed from prison. As the head of the New Jersey State Policemen's Benevolent Association put it in a letter. Oh, you mean the police union? Good old police unions, let's trust what they say. And of course, Senator Catherine Cortez Masto of Nevada took the bait and said, I cannot support this nominee. Mr. Mungie's affiliation with the Alliance of Families for Justice is deeply concerning. The organization has sponsored a fellowship in the name of Kathy Boudin, a member of the domestic terrorist organization Weather Underground, and advocated for the release of individuals convicted of killing police officers. Okay, like, let's put aside, Kathy Boudin was, yes, I guess a terrorist in the 70s. She has since renounced everything that she did, which by the way, was not killing a cop. She was actually putting her hands up and the people who were with her were involved in that. She served decades in prison for it. She passed last year. And she has since worked around political prisoner rights. She is not, the idea that they had a fellowship and then he spoke at a thing. And it just, it is like, it is so wild to me. And these, they're just looking for excuses. Anyway, it looks like Masto's out. Manchin's probably gonna hold out as well. He needs now 50 of the 51 Democratic caucusing members to support him in order to have his nomination go through. And according to the new, there's a new rule, which is just the most Biden rule. If they don't have Republican backing, he won't vote for them. Just one Republican. Oh, this is Manchin. Manchin said this. Of course he did. Manchin said, just one Republican. That's all I'm asking for. Give me something bipartisan. This is my own little filibuster. Bro, you are a walking filibuster. If they can't get one Republican, I vote for none. I've told Democrats that. I'm sick and tired of it. I can't take it anymore. I apologize to the shots fired at Joe Biden. That's a Joe Manchin thing, saying that he needs at least one Republican. This guy. Just leave already. Anyway, Democratic Senators John Tester, Tammy Baldwin also declined to say if they'd back Mungie. But Cenk, these loose affiliations, the organizations that advocate on behalf of people who are incarcerated, they are also very criminalized in this country. And it's seen as something awful to defend the rights of someone who is in prison, or to even ask that they have their sentences changed or released. They want them to just, you know, and I hate the way Democrats play into that as well.
Yeah, most important part, Franny, is that I don't believe them. So if they had said, like let's say Republicans said, hey, I'm not in favor of this nominee because he was just helping the prosecutors in Philadelphia and California, et cetera, with criminal justice reform, and I'm not in favor of that, and they're releasing too many prisoners in California, we could have that debate, right? And I could say, oh, well, that sounds like a legitimate opinion, whether you agree or disagree, right? But when a Democrat goes back to the Weather Underground in the 1970s to pretend that that's what she cares about, when she's obviously voting against this guy because some donor told her he's a no good Muslim and you are to, I order you to vote against him. Who are we kidding? Who are we kidding? It doesn't have anything to do with the Weather Underground. She's like, well, you know, I hear that he was in favor of Jeremy Bentham from the 1700s. And I am not a utilitarian, I will tell you that. And hence, I am voting against him. Yeah, you're a liar. It has nothing to do with that.
Yeah, it's such a reach.
Yeah, it is.
The reach.
Yeah, totally. I understand he was for William the Conqueror. And back in 1066, I was, you know, not in favor of conquering. And that's why I'm voting against him. Not because my donors told me to, because he's a Muslim and we're all racist. That's why we asked him about, hey, 9/11, aren't you responsible for 9/11? Apologize for 9/11. I meant weather underground. Did you? I don't believe you for one second. Okay, this is what like really offends everyone in DC, including the reporters. They get so emotional about this. I think that beloved Senator Catherine Cortez Masto, Democrat of Nevada, is a liar. I think she's voting against him because he's Muslim. And she doesn't give a damn about the weather underground. How could you say that, Cenk? She's a beloved, honorable politician. She's so honorable. How can you besmirch her honor? Why don't you just let her be racist? Yeah, no deal. No deal.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.